All right, now first thing we're gonna do, we're gonna go to the chalkboard over here, and I'm gonna teach y'all how to keep score in bowling. So if we can all come over here, let's go.
Michael got in an accident and will not be here. A golf cart hit him.
You got my card. There you go.
Yes, I'm missing Deidre, Daniel, and Michael.
Did you pick up Michael last week?
You got hit by a golf cart?
No.
No? Okay, you have tell me off camera, not on camera. Quick. Bowling, second to last day. Dylan's teaching.
Six pins, that would be the first, you put a six right here, that's the first roll. Let's say you knock down two pins on the second, two right there. So all together you have eight for that frame. Now, let's say you roll six on the first one, and four on the second. That would be a spare, because there's 10 pins total. So slap. Now, if you roll a spare, you get 10 for the first frame plus the first roll of the second. Let's say you roll 8 on the second. And 8. And 10 plus 8 is 18. So you have 18. Now we'll go to the strike. Strike means you roll the ball and knock down all the pins at once. So you have X. That's 10 in the first, and then your next two rolls gets added to it. So let's say you get a strike, roll an 8, and then a 1. Be 10 plus 8 plus 1, so that's 19. Everybody got that?
Yep.
Alright, let's say you roll three strikes in a row. Strike. Can someone tell me what my first score would be in the first frame?
30,
right. Because we had 10, roll another 10, another 10. That's 30. So you'd have 30 right here. What would the second frame be? Can someone tell me that? So let's say I roll an 8. Now what would my score be?
28.
So
58.
Plus 30.
58.
Good. Now let's say I roll a 1 right here. Can someone tell me the third one? 19 plus 58. 27. Good. Now we have a 9 right here. So we'd add it to 77.
86.
When's your bowling quiz?
Tonight.
February.
Is it due tonight?
We do have a it was
February.
Yeah, so it's a little, it's a very little quiz, but it's about scoring.
Okay, so I think we got that down. Now we're going to go to the last frame. This is where it gets a little tricky sometimes. Not everyone understands. So let's say we bowl an 8, and then we get the next 2, so it's a spare. We get one more roll, get an extra. So you'd have 10 plus, let's say you bowl a strike. You don't get to go again after that strike, but so you'll have 10 plus another 10. So you add 20 to the last frame.
What do you have to do to get to bowl in that last little frame?
You got to get at least a spare.
Yeah, at least a spare.
So a spare strike.
So if you had a 7 and a 1, you don't get to get in the last one.
Now let's say you get 3 strikes in those three frames. Some people think you just keep going, but you only get three rolls in that last frame no matter what. So let's say you get three strikes, you would just get 30 for this frame, add it to however many you have. And everyone understand how to score, because we're going to be scoring later on today. Any questions at all?
And let's move to spares.
Oh.
Let's move to spares.
All right, everyone, stand up, please, and gather around this yellow quadrant right here.
Probably if they're in front, they need to kind of
have a seat around just where you can see the pins, preferably over here. Oops, just make sure you can see the pins. I'm going to teach y'all how to pick up a spare. First, one pin, so you knock down 9 pins. Let's say we have this one, that's a common one, in that corner right there. What you want to do is, you want to square your shoulders to the pin on the opposite side. So you go, four step approach, and then hold, just aim for that pin. Just like you were bowling a strike. Same thing for the opposite side. Now let's say, we have these two right left. Do the same thing, except you're going to always go aim for the key pin, which is the lead pin. So that'll be the one in front. So you just go and you'll aim for that lead pin. You want to roll it straight. So it comes straight this way. You'll hit the pin right here, it'll knock both of them down.
Can someone tell us what those arrows up there are for in relation to spares? For aiming how? What do you do? How do you aim?
Well, it helps you aiming like so you don't lose your track. So when he says you come like in front of it, if you hit that third arrow there, it goes right where he's saying.
Right.
Just make your life
easier. Arrow pointing to each dot. Yeah. Each row of the dots.
You kind of look like down a barrel of a gun, you know, and line it up.
Right there, and the next one points.
So people don't look at the pins when they bowl, they look at the arrow. And if they roll it over the arrow, then it'll go there to the pin.
You'll find it's a lot easier to aim at the arrow than it is to aim at the pin. Just because it's closer to you, depth perception is better. All right, now let's... This is a little bit trickier. Right here, you want to aim for that lead pin, but you want to aim to the left of it so that this pin will knock down that pin. So if you aim right here, just do that, and you'll hope that it hits that one. Or you can aim for the inside of it, so where the ball will hit this pin and bounce back and hit that pin. That one's a little bit more tricky. Spares can be true.
If you're using a straight ball to do it, where on number 5 do you need to hit the pin? On the outside. What's that going to cause it to do, Matt? Yeah, it'll ricochet. So if you just want to barely click the edge of it.
Yeah.
Most of you have more control over your straight balls because you're just beginners. So it's probably easier in your spare situation to use straight balls and use your hook for your knock them all down, Johnny pin, you know.
Yeah, so I would recommend, I'm going to teach you how to roll a hook in a minute. But for spares, I would recommend throwing a straight ball just because it's a lot more easier to control.
Yeah. They all know how to throw hooks, right? You've been doing that for 2 days.
Well, we're going to go over it again right now. So put these up. Let's see, I need 1, 2, 3, your group.
Balls are not going to fit the hands with big people.
Everyone have your group? Mm-hmm. All right, now y'all can just find a carpet lane, go to it. But yeah, there's one lane with, or two lanes without car. I don't get the call yet, please. You can go back into the group.
Dribble down the lane. Roll it. There we go.
Good job, player. Try rolling it a little bit more.
Need to,
Leo, whenever you're releasing product, really turn that wrist up.
Handshake position.
Handshake position.
And as soon as they get warmed up, you need to let them work on their spares just a little bit. Okay. Otherwise, they're not going to get a whole game now. Because the 50 minutes flies. I mean, it flies. But if they don't work on their the three different spares that you showed them, mm-hmm. Kevin, see if they can practice them. You can bounce now. While he was lecturing, it was drowning out the camera. But now that they're bowling, it should be fine. He's giving feedback. It's good. We need to get them practicing the thing you just showed them first, because they'll forget it. They forget where the pins were. See who can knock down that outside pin. I know Greg can do great, huh? Always accurate. It's easy if you've bowled, but if you've not bowled, it's not as easy as it looks. Yeah, everybody roll once. Over on the other side. You're on the wrong side of the lane, dear. You get over as far as you can. Give yourself as much lane as you can. If you're picking up this side, you need to scoot over on that side. Matt will show you how to do it.
I'm a hook bad.
You're not. Don't throw a hook. I mean, don't throw a curve. You threw a curve that last time.
I do it either way.
So you have a bad habit you're going to have. Oh, he's. Oh, he hooked his ball. We know you. He taught you the hook well.
Yeah.
It's hard. You got to think about it as a different sport.
I can go straight and it still hit like it. It feels bad.
I don't think it's your hand. I think it's your arm. Let's see if he can clip it. It only takes 100,000 hours to get good at bowling. Like anything else, it's a lot like pitching. It takes lots and lots of practice. This is the baby spare, right?
Good job, Leo.
That was nice. Okay. What mistakes are they all making?
Okay. Trying to look at them all.
Right. Most of them are standing in the exact same spot they stood for their first ball.
Mm-hmm.
That's the most common error. So before they go to the next one, when you freeze them again, then tell them, reiterate but you want to give yourself as the most lane as you can. You know, but you need to get, they heard part of it, but then they've forgotten part of it. Yeah, and you demonstrated that.
Yeah.
But they didn't think about it. Yeah. Once they start practicing, they forget everything.
Right.
Yeah. They're doing good.
All right. I just want to go over again, just to make sure you want to give yourself as much land as possible. So if it's on the right side, you want to stand as much to the left as you can, so you have the whole lane full. Now we're going to go to the second demonstration for yoga. Add another one in front.
Is that five? I think it was five.
Was that?
Five pin up? No, it wasn't.
Does everyone understand? Okay. Giving yourself as much land as possible.
Good. Yeah, so as far over as you can. No, not a bedpost. Bedpost is the hardest thing to pick up. Huh? It's not, though.
I know.
It's shorter. Well, the foul line is, yeah, it's shorter because you're dealing with little kids. It's this little kid. Oh, nice bounce there. He dribbled that ball well, didn't he? Had dribbled pretty. What's your name? I don't think, did you give me your card? I think you forgot, did you? Hey,
excuse me.
Yeah, you need to ask the teacher. Good job. You'd have lost points if you left and you not notice. Very good. Hey, knock them all down. Woo! Look at that. It's harder to do when you don't have a lane.
Yeah,
it's harder. This is harder. Yeah, because you just got to barely clip that.
The last lane, just put the pin in the middle. Like the last demonstration.
Yeah, there you go. It's hard. It's very hard. Let's see who gets it. Come on. Oh, no. Oh, he got it. Alonzo is great. He's the man. Slid right over. Spencer missed the whole thing there. No pressure at all. One roll and rotate. I do have some extra balls in the basket if your ball doesn't fit your hand. Where's the teacher? He looks like the teacher. He's staying on the perimeter. That's good. Good job.
We're going to start playing some real games now.
I do have prizes for the winners, so make sure people write down their scores correctly, double check each other that they don't lie about what they wrote down, right? I have prizes for the winners. It's a competitive game. But you're competing against everybody else that you're only competing with the other two people in your group. You're competing against people in your own lane. It's on. So yes, you're competing against those two boys.
No problem.
No problem. Don't mess around or you won't get your game done. Pull the box back just a little bit. It's kind of nice to be back there because it kind of slows down the pins a bit.
I'll let Jordy know what you think.
Yeah, thank you for letting me know. You're on top of it. The score should be up there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Keep the scoreboard over here on the ground.
Good. Okay. Okay.
All right, open up.
You probably need to back up a little, Sam. You're too close to the foul line, so it's giving you trouble. Look, y'all need to roll this thing the other way so it doesn't pop up. Roll it, you know, the other way for just a couple of minutes just to get that circle out of it. Because she messed up because of the foul line. It's because it got rolled from that end instead of the other end last time that caused that. If you roll the carpets from the other end, they won't do that. When they pick up at the end of the class, have them roll the pins from the lanes from the other end, and then they won't pop up in front of them.
Yeah.
I forgot to tell them to do that last time. It was a bad teacher. I think we're going to make it. I think the hard part is now over.
Yeah,
do not let anybody sneak out of class or you may have to help with scoring a little bit. You're on camera, and your high school and middle school kids will be able to see this in years to come.
I'm sorry.
Appropriate. Professional.
Did you see it?
Yes, I did. That is why you're only competing with the people on your lanes, because it's not fair with the other, you know, other people have different issues.
Mm-hmm.
It's harder without any lanes, isn't it? We have a pin setter. We have you should be setting up the pins. He should have rolled the ball back. And then you rotate. They don't know how to roll the pin.
Oh yeah.
Well, you're the grown-up, right?
Right.
So you have to make them do what they're supposed to do.
Gotcha. I'm going to go stand here and make sure.
Right. So, piece of cake.
Ma'am?
Piece of cake, you got this?
I think so.
Now, that is a hard thing to pick up right there. You'd have to hit the outside pin, probably. Or you could... Then he'll have a bedpost.
Which outside pin?
Either one. I mean, you hit and make them bounce over. If you don't think you can do that, you just take out the middle and leave a bedpost. That is not a good situation, no matter how you roll it. Why are you up here? You're supposed to be retrieving the ball. She sets up the pins. Then you... your rotation's off. He goes down. He's now the pin setter. She's the ball retriever, and you're the roller. Just roll the ball back to him. Is your turn to bowl? Then just roll it back to him.
Oh.
You're the ball retriever. He's the pin setter. He's the bowler.
Oh, okay.
The one that's on deck to bowl is the ball retriever. The one that just finished bowling is the pin setter.
I guess we didn't hear that because we had the one that stopped the ball that said, get the ball and come back here.
Yeah.
And then the one that just bowled goes and sets the pin.
Yeah. Person that, you have to write down your own score. Yeah. That he didn't review it today. So that's why we forgot. Wow. Look at that. Person on deck is the ball retriever. The person that just finished bowling is the pin setter. If you don't have kind of organized way to do it, you don't finish your 10 things. Run out of time. She challenges him.
Can you do it? Almost.
A heckler got him.
Thank you.
But I don't think I can claim this because it's too old. Steps, I think you'd have made it.
Good job.
You can unroll your foul line. It's probably straightened out by now. Yeah, that did it. They will go off in different directions later if they really get into bowling. But no foundation, hard to build off of.
I tried just one time.
Yeah, the no finger, the fingertip grip, there's no fingertip grip, there's curve balls, there's all this. But you see how fast those guys move when they bowl? They get some speed. Yeah. You can't control that. That ball will spin all over the place and not where you want it to if you try to do that. Oh, the pressure of the camera.
Good job. That was...
Every time I turn my camera on somebody, they mess up. You left one, Matthew. Woo! Left that famous famous pin up there, huh? Can Matt pick up the spare? This is the question. We're going to see if he can pick it up. He goes after the ball, it rolls, and he's got it, so he's got a spare. Let's see if... Can she pick up her spare? That's the question. She's trying to get 10 pins down. I'd make a horrible announcer, wouldn't I? Oh, good. She got the spare.
right?
Yeah, 25. Then you'll add.
Plus 10, plus 9, plus 10?
Wait, what's that?
Would it be 25 plus 10, plus you'll 9, plus
you'll
10?
Add 20 to that 25.
20 to 25, so it'd be 35 right here?
Oh, it'd be 45. So you have 10, and then you got another 10, so that's 20 to 20, add 20 to the 25, so it's 45.
So you just added both.
And you got a spare, and you won't know that one until you roll the
first. I thought you said a strike, you added this one plus this. Plus,
yeah.
So it'll be 10 plus 9 plus 10? Or plus 1?
Yeah.
Okay. 20, okay,
so and then you're after your next roll.
Well, now that was an unusual roll. If I was, because we have rubber balls, huh? It bounces like a basketball. In about 2 minutes, you're going to have to start picking up because we've got to be sitting over there at 15 after.
Okay.
Well, then we have no reflection time, do we? Just seeing how many lanes we have.